Sumo Logic is a highly flexible and scalable solution, and it can work for any size organization. However, with so much flexibility at your fingertips, what is the best way to design your Sumo Logic deployment? In this video, we will talk about how to identify a data collection strategy that best fits your environment and implement best practices around data collection. You can start by asking yourself three questions. What do you want to know from the application? What are the resources available to you? And where does the data reside? Sumo Logic uses different collectors to manage data. A collector is a small application that gathers logs, metrics, and transaction data from your servers and sends it to the Sumo Logic cloud. Installed collectors are configured on systems in your deployment, and hosted collectors are used to collect data from various services like Amazon S3 or over HTTP. The Sumo Logic OpenTelemetry Collector is our next generation collector, built on the OpenTelemetry framework that provides a single unified agent to send logs, metrics, traces, and metadata for observability to Sumo Logic. From the infrastructure to the application to your end users, OpenTelemetry gives you comprehensive visibility into the health and performance of every level of the stack. You can choose to install a number of collectors to keep your topology simple or centralized, or install many collectors on different target hosts locally to distribute the bandwidth across your network. There are three types of data collections: local, hosted or cloud, and centralized. Often organizations end up with a mix of local and centralized data collection. The local method collects all data locally from each individual system, and the centralized method uses installed collectors with remote file sources or a local file source like syslog to collect data in a centralized location before sending it to Sumo Logic. Let's move on to best practices for each method. Customers using the local data collection method usually have a large number of target hosts. They have target hosts either on-premise or in cloud instances. Additionally, they can automate deployments and configuration if they are large. The local method is beneficial as there is no requirement of additional hardware and gives you direct access to your logs. It makes troubleshooting easy with automation through scripting, puppets, and so on. However, a possible drawback includes the need for outbound internet access, which may present a firewall and security issue. It requires software installation and uses resources on the target hosts. Let's consider a scenario of customers using cloud infrastructure. Unlike installed collectors, hosted collectors don't require installation or activation, nor do they have physical requirements since they're hosted in the cloud. Since there are no performance issues to consider, you can configure as many S3 and HTTP sources as you'd like for a single hosted collector. The only possible drawback is that it requires HTTPS post-caching. Customers using the centralized method usually have the existing log infrastructure in place that can be leveraged. The method is beneficial for file sources as there are no changes on target hosts. For syslog, centralized log collection is a familiar method. It provides no outbound internet access, fewer collectors, and no software installation required on production machines. However, it may present problems when you scale the solution. It requires dedicated hardware and increased network bandwidth. With scaling, it gets more difficult to troubleshoot. There are multiple ways to deploy data collection methods, and it really depends on your requirements. Here is a summary table to help you design a deployment that works for your organization, is scalable, and is easy to administer and maintain. Here, you see the Sumo UI and options to select your collector. Sumo Logic's OpenTelemetry collector supports logs, metrics, and tracing, and it's lightweight and vendor agnostic. It is an ideal choice for organizations looking to gain a deeper understanding of their distributed systems and improve their overall performance and reliability. Hope you enjoyed this video. Thanks for joining.